Panasonic EVO One has three video outputs. It has the LCD monitor output, and it has an SDI video output, and it has an HDMI video output. One of the neat things that the EVO One can do is it can route different signals to different monitors. Because sometimes people on your production don't need to see everything. Sometimes they may want to see different things than someone else is viewing. For example, let's say you're the camera operator and you're shooting in V-Log. Now, V-Log is a very flat gamma, very, very flat image. It doesn't look great directly on a monitor because it's not meant to be viewed directly on a monitor. It's meant to be graded in post to draw out its color and the saturation and the gamma and the curves and everything like that. You're supposed to do all that. But maybe the camera operator wants to monitor in V-Log. Well, you can configure the camera to output V-Log to the LCD. And maybe we're using an external recorder, maybe an external HDMI recorder. We can output the V-Log signal from the HDMI. But maybe to the client, we want to output the SDI. We're going to have a client monitor set up where we want to show the richness, the colors, more like what it would look after it's been graded. Well, we can go into the menus here and we can configure the LCD and the HDMI to receive the V-Log signal. And we can configure the SDI to have a V709 gamma laid over it. So now, instead of looking at washed out flat footage and the client saying, "What is wrong with this? I thought you people were supposed to be good. I hired you to deliver me good footage." You don't have to fight that battle at all. Give them the V709 outlook, and now it looks glorious and beautiful, but you are able to internally and externally record the true V-Log signal so that you can then grade it in post exactly the way you want it. Another thing you can do is you can determine who gets camera overlays. Maybe the camera operator wants to see every piece of information. So maybe on the LCD, we want to put out, you know, the white balance and the zoom focal length and the shutter speed and the frame markers and guidelines and the waveform monitor and zebras and all that kind of stuff. Camera operator wants to get that. Maybe you got a monitor running out to the department heads, you know, makeup and wardrobe, props, they're all monitoring and they don't need to see any of that stuff. You can configure that output to be clean, devoid of all those overlays. And you can do that for either the SDI or the HDMI or both. You can configure the outputs to have only certain pieces. Let's say you only want the monitor to have the audio meters because maybe the sound department is watching it. And you want it to have time code because, you know, the script supervisor needs to be able to write down what the time code is. So you can send those pieces of information out, but then hide all the rest. Or maybe you have a camera operator who doesn't want to see any of that information. Maybe the director himself wants to operate for this shot. He doesn't want to be distracted with all this technical information. You can erase all of that from the LCD, and then you can have your camera operator, your normal camera operator, or your DP, monitoring the SDI output, and they're able to have all the information out where they need it. So they're still keeping track of all that info, and the director who's hand-holding the camera at this point can focus on framing. Here's another neat trick you can do. The LCD can be configured such that the SDI and or the HDMI ports will receive a mirror of whatever's on the LCD. So, you know, in past cameras, we may have a situation where you could see maybe the menus, you could see the screen display, but you couldn't see the waveform monitor or the zebras or various items like that, the focus assist. That's not the case with the EVO One. We can configure the video output ports to send a mirror of what the LCD is seeing. So that's a very handy way to distribute video. And you could set, you know, the mirror to be the LCD and the SDI, but not the HDMI. So you could have a camera assistant operating or watching focus and verifying for you on the SDI output and still have a full quality untouched signal going to an external HDMI recorder if that's, you know, the way you want to configure the camera. So you can route the outputs of the video in a lot of neat, interesting, and powerful ways. And that'll really help you take your production to the next level when you're working with the EVO One. Hope this information has been helpful and given you some insight into some of the possibilities of what you can do with this camera. For even more information on the EVO One, stay tuned to this channel for more tips and tricks on how to use your camcorder.
Panasonic,